And now, another episode of Crit Camp Gaming.
Oh yeah, it's episode 64, boys. We've made it this far, and look who's joining us tonight, everyone. The Akbun.
Right, yeah, I'm back.
He's back. He's waited this long to come back for season three. We had to kick off season three with the trio.
No? Three Musketeers?
Season three.
Everyone's like,
trio.
Tres.
Yep. Agreed. Everyone's in agreement. That's good. I'm glad we're in agreement. What's going on, everyone out there? All the campers hanging out. Thank you so much. Thanks for being patient. We had a couple camera issues on my end. We were getting Angelo back up to speed over there with Skype being a jerk. So we're glad to be seeing
you. It's been that long since I've been here. I have to update it. Seriously, man.
I think you had to recode Skype. Like, I think you were over there like, sorry, guys. I better get back into Skype here and make sure it's working. And I'm kind of laggy, I think, because Skype's messing with my other camera, and it's all good stuff. But what's up?
Yeah, Skype's being a punk.
Let's give some hellos to the people. Let's say, what's up, Evil Ed? What's up, Bill Padozzi? What's up, Majay?
Blip-a-doozy. He can't read.
Oh, yeah. Blip-a-doozy, man. Oh, man. My head needs some things. Blip-a-doozy.
Daff, Padres,
hey,
Grev.
Hey, Moscato's Majay. Here.
Yep.
And Lyle's here. Not just Angelo. We got Lyle, too. Padres Johnson. Oh, he'll be psyched tonight. And we've got Grev86. What's going on, guys? Thanks for saying hi to us tonight. And everyone else who will be joining us later on. I know we're a little late, so notification just went out to some of y'all if you've been following us. But thank you so much if you're following us. We're having some fun. Guys, did you guys have a good Memorial Day weekend or what?
I did, man. It was a good time.
Yeah, we actually all got together.
Yeah,
I know all IRL. Three of us IRL at my place.
Yeah,
had a picnic yesterday. It was pretty good.
Yeah, man.
Exhausting, but great. it was the first big party that me and Casey threw at the house, and I thought it was a success. I thought everybody had a good time. We had a great time, and it was pumped. And now our fridge is filled with food that I can just eat whenever I want.
Yeah, dude.
And not have to cook for like a week.
There was some good food too. What, we had a tomato pie. That was the first time I'd had a tomato pie.
Oh yeah,
tomato pie.
That's a central Pennsylvania staple right there.
Have you had it before, Angelo?
No, I didn't even know there was.
Did you eat
tomato pie? No,
you didn't even eat it, dude. I ate so much of it.
You didn't eat the tomato pie?
Yeah, tomato pie. If you guys have heard of tomato pie out there, that stuff was great. It was basically
If you say tomato pie, as in like pizza?
See, that's what I said. That's what I said. When Lyle was like,
okay, so it's called tomato pie, but what it really is it's kind of like deep dish pizza crust with tomato sauce on it, and that's about it. There's no cheese on it, so it's not really pizza.
It was really good, man.
Yeah.
You didn't see the giant pizza boxes that his wife's parents brought all the way from Pennsylvania?
Yeah, and my wife's uncle brought as well.
Yeah. Yemen saying it's just inverted pizza, bro. And my Jay, it sounds horrible. Dude, it's great. It's good stuff. It is. It was really good. I ate so much of it, man, that like at about 3:30 I woke up and I was like, I was like, man, all tomato sauce.
Reflux.
All tomato sauce, dude. It was like, it was so acidic. I just couldn't stop eating it. But then your dad made those kebabs, man. Those things were awesome.
Oh yeah, my dad did. My dad did some Filipino barbecue on a stick.
Oh yeah,
and he did. He did a pork variety, and he did a chicken kebab variety.
Mm.
We also got 8 foot of sandwich, 4 foot, which was Italian style,
yeah,
4 foot, which is was turkey. We had some pulled pork happening. We had some more standard mix sides.
Yeah.
Pasta salads and mac salads and all that good stuff.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah.
And that's all
I think. I just had a quarter of a strawberry rhubarb pie before stream. Felt really good about that.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it was good.
Well, it was good to see. It was good to hang out with Ange. It's good to see you and the little guys are looking good. We were busy chasing them all around, so.
Yeah.
Now, we had a lot of fun, man. I got burned. Rebecca, my wife, got super burned. It was a good time at the beach. But, there's your Crit Camp Cooking right there. And shout out to Emil, our Crit Camp Cooking chef now, who's been shooting us a picture. So if you guys haven't seen his awesome chef cooking, and if you guys make some awesome meals to sit down and have while you watch Crit Camp, we want to see him. We want to see him. The Crit Camp Cooking, man. It's been really cool. But, Yeah, other than that, I do want to, like I said, it's Memorial Day. So a Memorial Day special, we brought Ange. Ange is helping us kick off Season 3 with the first official mission, Gas Run, from Season 3, Rue Morgue. Let's do some promo teases here. I just wanted to promote a couple things. First thing, boom. We've mentioned it a couple times before, but on June 6th, Monday, June 6th, the guys over on Twitch's own Playing Board Games channel are going to be joining us as special guests to play some Zombicide. I think we've narrowed down what mission we're going to do with them, but we'll be hanging out with those guys. It's going to be a lot of fun supporting board games on Twitch.
So, that's awesome.
Yeah, you got to come meet those guys. They're pretty cool. They've been doing a lot of good stuff. Really looking forward to it. Another promo looking forward to. Here we go. Here we go. Here's a big community shout out. Boom. We'll be heading back to Ghostbusters. And with who? Our own Daftaru.
Oh my God.
It's going to be awesome. We got to remember how to play. But thank God we'll have Daphne joining us from chat. And she's going to come in and help us. Because, wow, I don't know if you remember, the last time we did this mission, way back, I think it was in March, we failed.
Yeah, we got beat. We got beat real bad. We got beat like we stole something.
Yeah. Oh, man. It was brutal. And at the end, I was watching it back, and I was like, wow, we were like... Because we made it too difficult.
Yeah,
all the
we added some stuff we probably shouldn't have added, and we let Chris drive the car.
Yeah,
and then we got slimed and we could not get unslimed and it was awesome.
Yeah, made a lot of bad decisions. So we're psyched to have her come join us. So come hang out, come meet another fellow camper. She's gonna come help us try to do this right, rather than yell at us, just like we bring you guys in, Majay and all those guys. It's gonna be awesome. Oh, and she's actually even saying there's a typo in the book. See? Insider information. She knows the game really well. She's a big Ghostbusters fan. So come hang out. We're going to talk Ghostbusters. Dave will be there to be super salty about the movie coming out. And we're going to have a lot of fun trying to get this scenario going correctly.
Yep.
And then one other thing I wanted to throw in here, because it was really cool and I was super psyched to see it over the weekend. Another fellow camper, Sean, sent us an awesome picture. Where is it? Right here. Sent us this photo. Hope he doesn't mind me showing this. I'm putting it up there. But there's Sean with one and only Danny Trejo.
Yellow Trustin Trejo.
Oh, yeah. Out at the Houston Comic Con. And he was falling down. Some of the best Zombicide cosplay we've been sent. And he gave us a shout out. And he's even got the character card there. So we're super psyched. Awesome cosplay, man. Really cool. Hope you didn't mind me throwing that up. But I just wanted to say that's some cool stuff. If you guys do some awesome cosplay or any cool artwork, painting minis, stuff like that, we do like to show it off. You know, if you're a member of the camp community, right on. We've got some of the best campers in Twitch. So right
or
on,
in
guys.
General, if you meet Danny Trejo, hit us up.
This cosplay, yeah, this picture is amazing. It's just amazing.
Yeah.
I couldn't even believe it.
I mean, look at that. The character card and everything walking around. We're going to have to do that one year, maybe New York Comic Con this year. Yeah, it was super. We'll have to put the card up with our thing and like, I don't know, maybe... I don't know. I'll go with Statham. Maybe you can go as Liam Neeson's. And then we'll, Andrew, who would you want to go as? Oh, you'll go as Fred.
Yeah.
That'd be a lot of fun. But, yeah, man.
Two for one.
Yeah, yeah, for sure, for sure. But other than that, those are some stuff coming up. So be sure to stay tuned. I do want to, there's a bunch of stuff I wanted to mention.
Chris is going to go as a giant too. Giant two die.
I can just walk around with a red shirt and just two dots. And everyone's like, I don't get it. And you're like, you will. Go to critcamp.com.
Yeah, you will.
you'll know real quick. But I did want to say that some good news. If you follow us on Twitter, I know people were kind of excited about this. This came in the mail from Cool Mini or Not. Boom, the rest of the Black Plague delivery. Ooh. We're not there yet. I know people are psyched. I think I just saw some more talk about Black Plague in chat. But we're waiting for the app to get the update. I think it's going to come in due time when they get everything shipped out to everyone. And once everyone has all the pieces. Otherwise, it'd be kind of wouldn't make sense to compete with themselves and stuff like that. Now that Cool Mini or Not Expo's over. But it's a huge box full of all the extra stuff we didn't get with the core game of Black Plague. So I'm super psyched. And one of the things we're going to play with tonight, bam. Check this out, boys.
Whoa, what is this?
Oh,
what? 3D doors? Could it be? Could we actually see the doors?
You will be able to see 3D doors. I'm using the Black Plague ones, but the square ones look good enough. I didn't on the other Kickstarter when they had 3D doors before and like all that stuff, I missed out on it. So I was like, I don't need those. And then I realized, man, that would have been super cool.
Yeah.
I know some of you guys out there got them, but No, I know. I've got Trejo's Taco shirt on in honor of Cholo, but I won't be playing Cholo tonight.
Yeah. What's Yemen is pumped about them doors,
dude. Get hyped. Hashtag 3D doors, Zombicide 3D doors. So these are gonna be cool. You get to see how those work. It was kind of fun putting them together. I was actually like building stuff. It was a lot of fun. But yeah, there's a lot of cool stuff in here, guys. And I just wanted to show really one of the really cool Black Plague minis. I know some people out there still haven't gotten the shipment yet, so I don't mean to be a spoiler or do a box opening and in a sort of brag. I just want to show you how cool this stuff is and to get excited, because we're going to have so many guys once we get into Black. But look how big this mini is.
Whoa.
And this is the Abomarat.
That's like Cthulhu Wars.
This is the Abomarat, I believe is what it's called.
Oh, dude.
This thing is giant.
It's like Zombie Splinter, dude. Oh, Zombie Splinter.
Zombie Splinter. Dude, it's going to be awesome busting out some of this new stuff. All the characters. Oh, and there's this guy too. This mini. This is like this. Forgot what he's called. I have to look up again. But another big abomination type. He has his own special rules, actually. I'd have to pull him out. Oh, here we go. There we go. The Obama beasts. So you got the Obama rat, Abomina Alpha, and the Abomina rat. So this is the Abomina Alpha. He's pretty crazy.
All right.
That's his giant mini that goes with it. So we got some cool art, some cool
giant
pieces.
Claws, dude. Giant claws.
Oh, dude, claws. It's
they're pretty sweet.
This stuff, it's gonna be, dude. Black Plague, man. I can't wait till we get into it. But we have a goal, and we're gonna beat this goal of getting there. We're gonna beat everything to get there. So stay tuned, guys. I hope you're excited, but it's gonna be exciting. And then, you know, everyone's talking about the rules with them. I don't know. Oh, we've got Game of Thrones jokes already happening. We're trying to avoid them because. I'm told we're still in the statute of limitations that we're not allowed to talk about it yet.
Come on, man. It broke the internet.
I know. That's what I was telling Lyle. I was like, everyone else is allowed to be an asshole, but we can't be assholes. Sorry for the families out there watching us and the kids.
I'm just saying, like from the dude that was just like, for 6 years, let's not talk about Game of Thrones. And then, like, now that he's current, he's like, I want to talk about it tomorrow. I want to talk about it now.
I want to talk about it because I'm not allowed to.
This week's episode was pretty good.
Yeah.
All right. How about?
Did you watch it today?
How about if we talk about
or yesterday?
If you want to talk about Game of Thrones, let me. Can I talk about the finale of Jessica Jones?
No.
Oh, you don't. You haven't seen Jessica Jones?
No, I'm only. Like, you already caught up. I thought you were only like a couple episodes in. Did you end it today?
What?
Or was that someone else I was talking?
Jessica Jones?
Yeah.
That was Matt.
Oh, Matt wasn't. You're caught up. You're done with Jessica Jones.
Yeah, Jessica Jones is really good.
I'm like six episodes in. I'm like five or six in.
I mean, that's more than 2 weeks past.
No.
Yeah.
The answer is no.
Dude, that was like back when was Jessica Jones?
It was a while ago.
It was like months ago.
It was actually
man.
Before the second season of Daredevil. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So no, we'll make an agreement. I won't mention Holding Doors as long as everyone else doesn't. Talk about Jessica Jones. Okay, fair, Lyle.
Whoa, Captain Napalm in the chat.
Oh, he wants to make sure we do this right.
Whoa, oh, that's been a long time.
Napalm's in the chat. Okay, so now we got to get. I just threw out all the Black Plague stuff. We're through that. Big thanks to Emil. Like I said earlier, we're talking our camp cooking. If you guys do a lot of cooking stuff, we're always doing that. Anything you put duck's tart on, definitely hit us up on that. So big thanks to him for sharing it on Facebook. Follow us on Facebook and get see some of his awesome cooking photos. It's pretty good, man. Have you guys seen that stuff? He's cooking salmon, I think it was, and eating salmon. And then he made some like stuffed peppers. Right, Lyle? Did you see that stuff?
No, it was pretty impressive.
Yeah, it was like stuffed jalapenos.
It's in good stuff.
Yeah, it was good. It looked really, really delicious. I wanted to eat it.
Yeah, he's going to be catering CritCon, I told him. So he's catering CritCon when it finally goes down. So careful. But speaking of Captain Napalm joining us in chat, I'm sorry this is taking a little bit because we're running late. But I did want to clarify some stuff. We did the tutorials, and we had to learn our lessons. And we did a few things wrong, and we didn't clarify a couple other things. So here's a couple things I wanted to mention. First off, when we were talking about the Boy Scout salutes, right? Three fingers together. Is the scout sign. Clarify that for me. Scouts is two fingers in a V. So the peace sign. I assume I'm doing this right, right? The Boy Scout handshake is a normal shake, but with the left hand. So it's just left to left, I guess, instead of right to right.
That's weird.
But wouldn't a left-handed person just do that anyway?
Left to left.
Left to left. Yeah, left to left.
Would a left-handed person do that? I think most people shake with their primary hand, which two-thirds of the population is on the right. So.
No, I thought it was like nine out of ten were right-handed.
Mm-hmm. Well, there you go.
Is that true?
I think it's 9 out of 10.
I come across a lot of left-handed people these days.
Well, there you go, guys. We learned that's first off.
I don't know.
So, there we go. We learned that about that. So I wanted some clarification. Thanks to Captain for clarifying that for us. A little respect on that. And then here we go. I wanted to mention full auto. I think I described it right, and then we described it wrong, played it wrong, and then it was actually right the first time. So just to clarify, from Captain Napalm, he says, when resolving a ranged action with Miss Trish, who has the full auto ability, which allows you to... Survivor can replace the dice number of the ranged weapons he uses by the number of actors, meaning zombies or survivors, standing in the targeted zone, including the other survivors and the survivor himself.
In the targeted zone. Yeah.
Targeted being the key word here. So that means if there's six zombies or characters, actors, in that zone I'm firing into with a pistol who gets one shot, it means I get six dice to try to hit it. So there's the clarification on that, so we'll be sure we play that right. And skills affecting the dice value, like plus one die to ranged, still apply as well. So I would get one extra dice with that kind of bonus. So, once again, she's kind of OP, man.
OP. I mean, in either case, I think she's OP, but she's even more OP.
Oh, yeah, she's great. Way. Yeah, and he just wanted to say she encourages grouping the zombies together and staying together as a team. She loves holes and barricades and closed doors that make zombies cluster together. That's a cool thing to think about. And it works really well with weapons with low hit numbers, like the bow or dual wielding weapons. Full auto is basically a car attack with a gun. So it's perfect for me because I don't have to drive a car. Am I right? Okay. So there we go. A little clarification, a little bit more from Captain Napalm. We appreciate it, guys. If you guys have any clarifications and stuff, definitely leave them in the YouTube comments. Hit us up in chat. We'll try to catch that as we're playing and do it right with all you awesome QCers out there. Really appreciate it. Lyle, what are you drinking before we jump into this? And what are you guys drinking in chat?
I am drinking water because I drank a lot this weekend and I need to hydrate myself.
Dude, you guys made that cucumber stuff? That cucumber.
We made 3
lemonade?
Gallons of gin cucumber lemonade, and then we had like a bunch of cases of beer. More people brought beer, and then we had a whole case of rosé. I think we had some other stuff too, but so that's basically.
Yeah, you didn't have a lot of options for a teetotaler. I had to drink juice all day.
We had water. We had water, and then we had some juice boxes for the kids.
Yeah, Avery was crushing those. I went over because I was all dehydrated from being at the beach and drinking beer like constantly. So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to drink some of this nice lemonade. And I poured a big old solo cup full of it. And I was like, it's going to be refreshing. It's got cucumber in it and this lemonade. Look at that. It's all refreshing. I'm like, glug, glug. What? I was like, there's something in that. And then Sam.
We found out later that people were like, that was really strong lemonade.
It was,
we were like,
dude.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, I was like, wow. I was like, Rebecca, you're driving home. Angela, what are you drinking?
I am drinking Arizona iced tea.
Ooh, Arizona iced tea. What flavor is that?
Oh, well, all right.
Just lemon flavor.
Oh, lemon flavor? You didn't go with the, what's the golfer guy?
Lemony Fresh. Oh, Arnold Palmer.
You gotta get
Arnold Palmer.
Got to get the Arnold. Or is that its own brand? That's Arizona, right?
Or the honey green tea, which is a throwback to college days.
Yeah.
Dude, you had packs of
a gallon of honey green tea at the Hess station.
Was your argument that it's green tea that it's good for you?
No, it was just like, you know, the midnight run to the Hess station. Me and Dan would get a bunch of cigarettes and a gallon of honey green tea. And some scratch off tickets.
It's like pure sugar water, right?
Crosswords. We were obsessed.
Yeah, we would do the scratch off the crosswords one and hope for the best because you get the best bang for your buck for as much time it takes you to do that ticket.
There you go. And Angela's really good at crosswords, so there you go.
I don't know. It's been a while.
It's been a while. We used to do crosswords all the time. Every day we were doing what, like the New York Times and the LA Times and like the Chicago Sun Times online MSNBC crosswords.
Jesus, man. I remember when I first met Angelo, we were playing, it was a poker night, and he's over there killing a crossword puzzle while playing poker. And I'm like, how are you doing this? Like, what are you doing? Who are you, man? Oh, and Napalm saying the story behind the shake comes from Baden-Powell's days in Africa. African warriors would shake with their left hands to show trust because they had to drop their shields. Makes sense.
Interesting.
There you go. Right on. And yes, Daphne, you do need to get Ecto Cooler for Ghostbusters and everyone else out there too. And there's a good, I'll tell you, there's a good, it doesn't taste the same or anything, but you can get the really green, what is it? Not Kool-Aid, but Gatorade. If you want an Ecto Cooler like drink for your parties. Good time.
All right.
Yeah. But what's that? Okay. I'm drinking a Terrapin chocolate peanut butter porter. Speaking of porters, I'm actually drinking, well, it's not a porter, it's a stout. But so Rebecca for my birthday got me a monthly craft beer thing, which is kind of cool. So if anyone out there, I think this is from Kansas, it's from Free State Brewing. It's called, that's their oatmeal stout, Free State beer. So I'll be taking a drink of that and drinking a Free State beer. So I'm back on it.
From where? From where?
I think it's Kansas. Isn't that the Free State? Great Plains
region?
Oh,
when I was when I was in Kansas, I drank a beer at the Blind Tiger Brewery.
Blind Tiger?
Yeah.
You didn't go to Free State Brewing, Lawrence, yeah. Kansas. Anyone out in Lawrence, Kansas?
No. Wait, where?
Lawrence, Kansas.
Lawrence, Kansas?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, I passed by Lawrence, Kansas, and I was this close to stopping, and we stopped in Topeka instead. But Lawrence, for those Supernatural fans, is where the Winchester brothers were born. And so when I passed Lawrence, I tweeted right at Shannon and her podcast.
Oh, the yeah. Fans.
And I was like, guys, I'm passing. This is where it all began. This is where it all began right here in Lawrence, Kansas. Sorry. That was it. I was really pumped about it. Casey thought I was stupid, but I was really pumped.
You were super psyched. Padre Johnson saying, have we tried Zombie Killer or anyone tried Zombie Killer by Bee Nectar? No, dude. I'm going to look it up. That sounds awesome. That sounds great. Any other beer things? Definitely hit up. Drinking lychee flavored Boris? What is that, man?
Lychee.
It's lychee, right? It's like lychee tea, right? Or lychee that's like you get that at Chinese. Not
lychee
Chinese.
Like the fruit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That stuff's pretty good. Nice, nice. And Evil Ed's from Chattanooga, Hawaii. Right on, man. You guys are all from Hawaii. That's what I assume. For sure. All right. So let's get into this mission, guys. It's a good time. We've got some stuff to talk about. Oh, I did want to mention before we get into it, I have to mention one last thing. The Naruto board game has been officially released, and I ordered it. Oh, yeah. From Japanime Games. It's coming.
Hang it.
Co-op. Kakashi Sensei. Call it. Oh, yeah.
It's like
Shadow Clones. Coming at you, dude. Shadow Clones.
It's like...
Okay.
Rasengan!
No, you don't need signs for the Rasengan.
Oh, no, I need you. I need you to do this, and I need to... You have to sit there.
Yeah.
Early
I'll
on.
Mold the chakra.
Yeah.
I will infuse it with lightning.
Yes. We'll have an awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. Whatever. So or there wind, you go, guys. That game is going to be coming to stream, hopefully. Hopefully I can make it work because we totally got to play the Naruto game. It's awesome. Love Naruto. Hope you got Naruto fans out there. I even took down my Naruto poster. Might have to get that back up. The one we never knew what it said.
Rebecca's going to love that.
Yeah. And Massive Darkness comes out tomorrow, actually. No, June 7th. Not. Next week. 1 week from today, tomorrow, Massive Darkness from Cool Minionaut comes up. So get excited. And what's up, JXM? Thanks for joining us. Let's get into this. We can talk about all kinds of good stuff. Mission number one, Zombicide, Season 3, Rue Morgue. Lyle, let's talk about the mission.
All right.
All right. Do you want me to read the lore?
Do the lore.
We need a generous. It's called
do
Gas Run.
You always do the lore.
Here we go. We need a generous fuel reserve if we want to explore the surrounding cities. We found a helicopter at a clinic. It seems disabled, and we can't access it right now. The door is firmly locked. As far as we can see, someone was living here and put up an epic gunfight before leaving. Or falling. okay? Zombies are still roaming around as we explore the area for clues. Wait! Kathy located the survivor's last stand. It's just across the street in a remote gun room. All we have to do is plunder the building and open the way to the helicopter. We could even find a few useful things the guys used to own. If we are quick enough, we can do everything before the zombies overrun us. I pray they had batteries. Listening to some music would feel like heaven. Yeah.
All right.
Like heaven.
Cool. Nice ending, dude.
Where's my yeah? Oh, whatever. I lost it. Okay.
These bumpers have been great, man.
It really is like one of the best sound clips, dude.
I love that. I love Tia Carrera doing that. Oh, good. All right, dude. What are we doing in this mission?
Basically, what we have to do is we start at the blue player tile, at the top right of the map. And when we're actually playing the map, we're going to be rotating this 90 degrees. But if you're looking on the mission page, we start at the top right, the blue player zone, and we just have to get all starting survivors in the exit zone during the end phase. So the helicopter zone is the exit zone is at the helicopter zone at the bottom right. Mm-hmm. And basically, we have to make our way through. And to get down there to the helicopter, we're going to have to open this blue door, which we have to get the blue objective to open that door first. And so there are other red objectives that are also on the map, which it didn't seem like we actually have to take them. But whoever takes an objective will get 5 experience points. So maybe we just want to get that to level people up. Who knows?
Sure.
And the other special rule is that the helicopter itself can't be flown. So we just have to make our way through the building, get the blue X, go down, open the blue door, and get to the helipad.
Yep, that's pretty much it, man. So let's take a look at the full board, show you guys what's going on. We're going to be making our way to that blue X. Boom, we got the 3D doors. Look at that. Look at the door. Look at it.
3D doors.
Look at the door. It's open, bro.
Does it start open?
That one does, yes.
Oh, it starts open.
Yeah, this door starts open, which is pretty cool. Want to confirm that? Want me to confirm that?
Yeah, it is confirmed, dude.
Yeah, it's
boom. Confirmed. Dude, confirmed. Confirmed. Boom. So yeah, we start with the open door, and we start in this room here. I've got the shot kind of weird, guys. I'm not going to show the whole thing because we don't really need to, unless we absolutely have to. I'm just trying to show as much of the important stuff as we can. As we get further over to the west over there, I can move it. But as you can see, we've got the spawn points all numbered. That's the new Season 3 thing, so we'll be rolling for those with the brown dice today. Ooh,
Brown dice.
The brown dice for the spawns. Otherwise, yeah, that's the board, man. I think what's a little strat? Let's talk a little strat here. What's our strat?
Go for face.
Strat is just to get into that middle building.
Face at the place.
And search, get equipped, man. And then go, I just say we just go straight for that blue X.
So you're saying we should maybe just not search immediately and just go?
Oh, I forget. We don't all have to survive, right?
I believe so.
We all have to survive.
Yeah, we all we need do. To make it, yeah.
We all have to survive. When we open that door, we're going to have to spawn the whole damn thing. So I do think that we should take at least one round to do some search and then jump in and YOLO. But, you know, we're in blue, so nothing so terrible can really happen to us. So if we do YOLO it, then I think we could probably make our way through anyway.
Yeah, I say we just YOLO. That's my point.
YOLO rag.
Oh, you want to just YOLO?
Yeah.
Okay. You know I'm always down for the YOLO.
We're always faces the place. You're back, Angelo. We got to do the. We got to go.
Listen, if we lose fast, we can always reset.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
You just queue it up.
Yeah, queue it up. Queue back up, man. Queue back up.
Queue it up. Rack them up, dude. Rack them up.
So who are we going with tonight? You want to know who we're going with tonight before we just epically die? We're going with... I'm starting with Travis. So we played with a few characters as much as we could through the tutorials, some of the base characters. Travis is one of those base characters. He has Reaper Combat, man. He's the new Fred. Really dug it. It was helpful when we thought things were over with. He came back and saved the day. So super happy about that. Mm-hmm. Hey, what's up, Trail? Thanks for hanging out. So yeah, I'm going to go with Travis again. If you're not familiar with Reaper Combat... Boom, use a skill when assigning hits. Thanks for the follow. Oh, I just killed our stream.
You killed our stream?
Whoops. That stream went down. Stream drop. I hit the stop stream button on accident. Sorry guys, I wanted to thank Mr. Sure, Trail for the host, and I hit the stop stream as soon as he got hosted. And I was like, stop stream.
No, it's up.
Oh, it's up.
I
okay.
Don't know. Okay.
Never happened. Nothing happened. Ignore what I said. So there's Reaper combat, guys. you get to kill one more of the same zombie that you killed
production?
Originally. Yeah, production quality. It's been a good night so far. Good night. So I'm going with Travis. Second, I'll be going with Miss Trish.
Nice.
Now, we just discussed Miss Trish and doing that kind of thing. So
in the full auto.
Yeah, full auto, describing how that works exactly there, once again, is the description. She's awesome. I don't have her mini. I don't know why, so I'm just going to be using a pink mini, female mini, on the board. So that'll represent Miss Trish, just so all you guys know. But full auto is awesome. All right, Lyle, who are you going with?
I'm going with Bear, who's also part of the Season 3 included guys, mainly because he has this shove ability, which could be useful to us.
Sure.
And that's pretty much it.
You get to use shove for free.
Oh, yeah. Though. Shove is if there are zombies in the zone with him, he could shove all the zombies into an adjacent zone.
Yeah, man. That was really helpful. Really helpful. Really helpful there. Boom. He got Bear. Continue. All right, Padre Johnson. There he is.
And for Padre Johnson, I'm playing Padre Johnson. Because I was originally going to do my man Liam Neeson's, but we were talking before the stream that since we're actually adding in all of those, all the zombies from like Season 1 to Toxic City Mall, we actually might need some super strength. So I brought him back. I called him from the bullpen. I was like, I need the big man. What is this? Where are we? Oh,
Wolfsburg. Twisted Trail was asking if we got Wolfsburg. It did come in that box. Like I said, I'm not gonna show everything that came in the box, but look, it's got shinies too. There, do that better. So yes, it's out. It's coming, guys.
It comes with holograms, dude.
Yeah, it comes with holograms. Yeah, 3D holographic zombies. That'll be great to try to see on air. No, I did want to mention, we are, like you mentioned, we're playing with Season 1, 2, 3. So we are playing in the deck, the equipment deck. I threw in the Toxic City Mall cards so we could get, like, Toxic Bloodstray masks in some of those weapons that help us kill off some of those bombs. Just so you guys know, I'm not playing with any of the Season 2 equipment or Season 1 equipment. Just the Season 3 base and the Toxic City Mall expansion. Okay, Mange, who are you going with here?
We're with Parker. First, I just want to pick some of the new characters.
Yeah, dude.
Because I'm unfamiliar with any of them.
Right.
So I wanted to give them a good, go around.
Yeah.
I saw that we didn't have anyone with the medic ability, so I thought she was a pretty good pick, especially if we're going to go YOLO.
Yeah, man. YOLO. And she's one of the new standard characters that comes with Season 3, I believe, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can heal someone, get rid of a wound. All right, man.
Right.
Playing priest tonight.
And Joe, I figured since we would need to be equipped right off the bat, pick Scavenger. I think that's we could search anywhere, right? Even streets.
Yep.
So, yeah, you can search anywhere.
Yeah, we don't have. I don't have to stay in a room. I could search out in the streets, et cetera. So
yeah, we played like him. I think in the first tutorial, I used him, and he was pretty awesome. Helps get geared up when you're in like a tight point. You can just keep moving. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like you don't have to think twice about where you're at. But awesome, man. So that's our team for tonight. Let's see what this starts us as. Boom. So it'll auto-gear us up. I'm not sure. So it'll give me the bow, crowbar, fire axe, crowbar, bow, and fire axe. So that's what we're starting with, guys. Good and good?
Yeah.
That's sort of a nice little thing. Nice little tone. So we got Joe, Parker. with our strat, who did we want to start first?
I'll start with my guys. I'll just bust open the door.
So we're gonna go face.
Is that what we want to do?
Yeah, Miss Trish has got the thing there. Yeah, I'm cool with that. And you good with that?
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, it looks like we all have some way to open a door.
I mean, we all have something, so it doesn't really matter.
But you have two ways to open a door, so. You could search and open a door. Or do we want you to go last because you have Bear? in case we get in a situation.
Yeah, okay, we can do that.
You know, if we get spawn on the zones, we get an activation.
We're not going to get an activation in blue.
Oh, true. This guy, next level. Yeah, oh, look at that.
Oh, air server.
Oh my god, this is freaking. Anybody out there work for this company? I'm done. I'm done with it. I'm just done. All right, we'll bring it back. But that sounds good. So, let's just start. You want to go first? You said.
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool. That's cool. Hey guys.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, nothing happened.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, let me make sure the gameplay is good. It's going to look laggy for a second. next level. Chat amongst yourselves. Okay, here we go. You guys ready?
Yep.
All right, and check it out. Here's our great community chatting on the bottom right side. So you guys can see what we're talking about. It's a good stuff. Boom. I'm talking about Air Server. Apple. Am I talking about Apple? No, I'm talking about about Air Server we use as a mirroring software. It always just like disconnects me. Or if you're super familiar with Air Server, you can maybe let me know why. It like almost times out during the show. Always during the show. I think it was up the whole time until we go live. And then it decides to see ya.
Yeah. And also if anybody works for Skype.
Yeah. Yeah.
Why so bad when we stream?
Why are you mad though? Yeah, well, I think everybody that uses Skype for podcasts hates podcasters and people making shows with Skype. All right, man. Let's start it off, buddy.
Wait, what does Padre have? What does Padre
have? I think a crowbar.
A crowbar?
Yeah.
Let me start with Padre and then I'll do Bear.
All right.
Padre's going to go one to the west and open.
One to the west. Open it up.
No, you don't want to search?
Did you want to search first?
Oh, actually, yes. Yeah. Search, one to the east, and then open, yeah.
And you're going to go. Should I try it? When I use these doors.
Good call.
Yeah, good call, man. Look, you haven't missed a step, Ange. Mind you, would be proud.
Peace, good gaming.
Peace, good gaming. And he gets a Betty. The red weapon Betty. Right. Now you're going to go. So when I use these doors, do I have to shove your mini through the door just to be...
Wait, what can you do with these special red cards?
Work? No.
it doesn't work. Well, that's a missed opportunity.
I know. The base won't fit through.
Wait, what could you do with these special red weapons? Like, you could consume them, right, to get XP?
Yeah, check this out. I can zoom in.
You can consume them and get 5 XP whenever you want, or you can wait till you're red and then be really awesome.
Yeah.
Okay.
Have a super awesome chainsaw. Yeah. But that'll be once you hit red level, which is level 50, yeah. So then he's going to pop the door.
Yeah.
Yep, pop it.
Dude, we need the door sound effect. Wow, you got to do it. It's open. Okay, let's spawn these things. So we're spawning every single
room. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 rooms.
Yeah. 8 rooms it is. I gotta get
it. Let's start at the blue.
Okay.
And work our way
back towards the door.
Back. But do the door that's right in front last.
Okay. So right to left up top. Okay. Let's spawn these things. Ooh, nothing. Still cool. Blue.
Still cool.
One walker.
Every manhole. We're on 2 different tiles.
It says, good catch.
And in my zone, yep. That was the second one.
That's it, yep. One walker.
And third room. It's a runner. Oh, wait, no, it's a walker. Okay, corner room.
Toxic runner.
And that's a blue.
Yeah, man. We're playing with a lot of different cards here, guys.
Yeah.
Skinner. Here's your first Skinner. Oh.
Skinner?
Oh, and I forgot to play the toxic sound. There you go. Okay, there's a Skinner from season 3. I guess they might look a little bit more
the
yellow.
X-room.
Oh, we got no Skinners.
Nothing.
And then,
all right, do the other X room.
Okay. Ooh, we got the toxic. Here we go, because I missed it last time. Another runner. Another toxic.
Okay,
runner.
Now the Ruben bonus. Yeah.
Oh my gosh. And then nothing. Skinner, Walker activation. No. Keep track of all these guys. Good luck.
Ooh.
So boom.
The Skinners get activations. Like the Toxics didn't get one, or the.
Yeah, I didn't realize that the Skinners
have activations.
Skinner ones get activations in blue.
Yeah, I think it's because they're base. Okay. Yeah, pretty crazy, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm going to search with Bear.
Okay, searches with Bear. Chainsaw. Okay. Oh, dude, you're super aggro.
Nice.
Okay.
Dude. Okay, now I'm going to jump in the zone and then chainsaw this guy.
Jumps in, whips out the chainsaw. Oh, so quiet. Ding, 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 ding. Here we go. Zero, nothing.
What?
Okay. And not even a two to account for. Three ones, and that's a three up top. Oh.
Okay. Well,
makes a noise.
Who is next after me? Do you want me to shove it back into the building so that you can hit it with a range attack, or do you want me to leave it there for a melee attack?
It's Angelo's, so it's Parker or Joe. It's up to you, Ange.
Oh, you have a free activation.
You want me to shove it back?
Yeah.
I have a free shove.
No, but everyone else has a... Almost everyone else has a melee, right?
Okay.
Because if you shove it... Huh?
Yeah, everyone's got a melee and a range.
If you want me to leave it, I'll leave it.
Yeah, just leave it, yeah.
Yeah. You want to leave it?
Okay.
All right, Angelo, Angelo not scared. Angelo don't care.
Okay.
All right, so it's Angelo's turn.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, what is this doing? Why does it say I'm starting? I forgot to do. I forgot to do the app thing. Like, I didn't order us up until after we got our gear. So hold on, let me do something.
It's either my turn or your turn, or it doesn't go sequentially, right? You just choose which one to go.
Right.
No, but
it's going to
end turn button.
Yeah, it's going to do a zombie.
Is it lighting up?
Okay, there we go.
Oh, I see. Yeah,
so I'm just doing this. So you, zombie turn, right? That doesn't exist. That was wrong. Just getting the app caught up. So Bear went, Padre went. Okay, now it's Parker's turn. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And then and then Angelo will go first.
Parker or Joe's turn. Yeah.
Yeah, Parker or Joe, Ange. That's the thing too. You can start with either one you want
to
activate. Yeah.
Yeah, you can choose which one.
Ew.
Yeah.
Oh, this is different. Actually, Parker. Whatever.
Oh, and Napalm's letting us remember that we've got a toxic runner, gonna be honest.
Yeah, I figured. So yeah. Parker.
Parker? Okay.
Yeah. Parker.
What do you want to start? Hardcore Parkour?
Searching.
Search.
Search.
You got the gasoline.
Gasolina.
Oh, man.
All right.
Okay.
All right, cool. All
right.
So so now with the Skinner abomination, we can possibly kill it. We can half kill it.
Yep.
With their gasoline, because we can't kill it with any 3 damage weapon.
Correct.
Just as a reminder.
Yes. All right, move up. And that's it.
Moves up, and that's it. So you're just going to move into the zone, man. Ready to rock. Mm-hmm. All right. Joe's going to save the day.
Search.
Searches. You got a zombie. Oh, man, where's my da? Where's my da? Man, I can't find all my stuff.
Da!
Okay, you got your... That's a toxic zombie. Or Skinner. A Skinner ambush.
What?
Yeah.
Okay, this is gonna be brutal. So you got a Skinner in there with you now.
This is great.
Attacking it,
yep,
I assume?
Yep, mm-hmm.
Whips it out. Oh!
Nothing.
Okay, I know it just went off the screen there, the screen cap, but you got a two. Welcome back to Crit Camp, Ange.
Great.
Gonna finish it off?
Yeah.
All right, go through again. Oh, whoops.
What?
Man, tonight I'm really on a roll, huh? All right, take your last swing here. Another two.
Oh, man. Wow. All right.
The doublet.
Oh. Great.
Dude, two twos in a row.
Right. Excellent turn, my friend.
Yeah, well played, dude. Now I gotta fight these things off. Okay, well, I guess.
You can't.
I guess Trish is gonna do it. Yeah, she's got her crowbar. So Trish is going to whip out her crowbar. Not by doing that. Whip it out. Come on. Yeah!
Okay.
There you go.
Skinner's dead. Okay, Skinner's dead.
You have to clean up this other walker that's there, too.
Yeah, I'm going to walk out. I can't search. And I'm going to do, come on, 2 crowbar kills in a row. Let's do this. Oh!
All right, there you go.
Miss Trish. OP, boys. Yeah. We got the crit. I made up for Angelo's shortcomings. Boom. That's 2. Dude, we ain't scared. We got nothing to worry about. We got 3D doors. Oh, I activated her. Her turn is over. Okay, Travis. Now, I could do something crazy with Travis. Travis. I could run in there and try to kill this thing with the bow. What do you think?
How can you kill it with a bow?
It's a ranged weapon. I mean, I can go 1-2 spaces and then take a shot at the toxic runner.
Oh.
Of course, if I miss, he's going to hit me.
You can YOLO it.
Yeah? No? Oh, can't hear me right now.
What is it, 3+?
Oh, Lyle disappeared. Hopefully he comes back in the right box. So it's me and you, Ange.
All right. So what's the... Whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa. Right. There you go.
Oh. Here's the kitty cat. High risk, high reward, Napalm saying. Worst case, we have the medic, Myjay saying.
What is it, 3+?
Yeah, 3+ to hit. Or shove on the next turn. I think it's worth it. If we're going face.
Yeah, let's go face. Go, do it.
Okay, we're going for it?
You'll take a hit, right?
Lyle, are you back? Lyle doesn't know what's going on, but we're just going rad, dude. We're just going all the way. 1-2. Okay, man, let's do it. Let's bow this thing. I like having you back, Ange. You're all about it, dude. Everyone's saying go for it.
fun time.
Oh, that didn't go so well. Welcome back, Ange. Welcome to Crit Camp, everyone else.
All right.
This is how Crit Camp started. Not rolling crits. So now we have to move the zombies. So that means everyone's going to first attack. They can't attack. So then they move, and they get 2 actions. So this runner, boom, and I get bit.
Yeah, bit up.
So Travis gets bit and loses his bow. Man, that sucks. Okay. So we lost the bow. That's no good. Travis loses the bow, and then everyone else moves.
Well, I gotta get back in frame.
This is going well, guys. Bow down, got hurt. Lyle's gone again.
Yeah, Lyle's gone.
It'd be great if I appeared in your bathroom, like right over here.
Yeah. I'm like at a 45 degree angle right now, just to get into frame here.
Okay, let's do some zombie spawning. So the way this works now, if you missed our tutorials and Lyle's trying to come back again, Casey's in the other room watching Game of Thrones, catching up on it right now, is that I have to roll and the numbers on the board determine where they spawn at.
Oh, okay.
So we got...
So you add them up? Oh.
6. 4, 5. So go. So basically I get 1 on the 2, 3. I get 2 on the 4, 5. And then 1 on the 6 spot up there. So as we go around the board, that means we have to spawn, you know, none on the 1 spot, which is great. We got to do 1 in the 2, 3 spot. So I got a Skinner. There we go. We got a
Skinner.
So we got a Skinner just to the south of us. 3, 4. We got another Skinner.
Skinner.
4, 5. We got a Skinner, and we get another Skinner.
Skinner.
And then we got 1 at the 6 spot. So the reason we're rolling 4 dice, if anyone's wondering.
Skinner!
The reason we roll 4 dice is because we have 6 survivors. If you have any more than that, like, they go up and you roll more dice accordingly.
I see.
So we have 6 survivors, we're rolling 4 dice. Boom, are you back, Lyle? Lyle?
Hello, hello?
Did you make it back?
Can you hear me?
Yeah?
Yeah, we can hear you.
I can barely hear you guys, but I can at least decipher you through robot...
What?
Robot-y voices.
Tell everyone to stop downloading a new episode of Game of Thrones. So recap for you. We went YOLO. It failed. I lost my bow.
Angela, wait, went YOLO?
I went YOLO. I went YOLO, with my dude, and we lost the bow. And I have one wound.
Okay. So I'm next, huh?
Yeah, you're next. You can start with Parker or Joe. That was round one.
All right. Maybe Joe.
You're going to come heal me?
Yeah. Right, Joe. So I'm going to move up two spots.
That's right. You're back there.
Okay. Yeah. I'll take a swing. So wait, if I kill the toxic, I get the blood spray, right?
You get blood spray.
Okay, man, you don't care. We're just going for it, huh?
Yeah.
We ain't scared of no blood spray. Oh, we got him. Crit. Makes up for it.
Yo, crit should be like a clean cut, like a clean kill.
Yeah, exactly. So you get hit, so you actually lose your fire axe.
You actually lose that fire axe.
And you get a wound.
Boo.
But you're a medic, so you still... Oh, no. You have a medic. Joe is not the medic. Good job. I love how we're just getting toxic blood spray left and right.
I don't know what's going on right now.
Parker's turn.
Move up.
Move up.
Okay. Oh, what's the targeting priority?
The new targeting priority?
Yeah.
Skinners are last.
Yeah, Skinners are last.
Okay. Skinners,
no matter what.
But it's still Walker.
Yeah,
Walker,
fatty runner.
So when you shoot it, yeah, Survivor, Toxic Walker is first. Standard Walker, Skinner Walker are the same priority, and then Berserker.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, yeah.
If there's a crawler that appears, that's always last. It's like a zombie dog.
Okay.
So
yeah, because they got apparently less.
Right, they're harder to hit.
Areas to target, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So the Toxic Runner would be hit after the Skinner
Walker. After the Skinner Walker.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Shooter.
Shooter.
Yeah.
Okay, so the Skinner going to try to kill it. Come on, man. Got him. Boom.
Good. Okay.
Did you do the thump? Wow. Good, because the sound effects are all down. All right, man, you got one.
All right.
Finish the job?
Shooter.
Love this bow, dude. The bow's awesome. Plus, if you roll a crit, Ange, with the bow, I can't double tap this, you get plus one damage for each six.
Nice.
So roll a crit. Oh, he does it.
Oh, he does it.
Great. Overkill. Nice, dude. That's a third crit.
I saw that the fatty got highlighted when the...
Yeah.
Oh, when it lit up? Yeah, man. Look at you.
Yeah, when it lit up.
Yeah, man. Next level app, dude. App updates.
Okay.
Then you can heal for free.
Yeah, I'll heal Travis.
Thanks, man. Because you agreed to send me in, right?
Yeah. I feel guilty.
JXM's asking about the stream setup. I've been emailed a few times about it. I can give you a few recommendations on things, but it's constantly evolving. You'll hear us complain about elements of it and then have to change them. So it's come a long way. If you go to YouTube and watch, you'll pretty much be able to figure out everything that we've used and then gotten rid of or changed. So we hope to make some more changes, but if you have any recommendations, we'll totally take them too. I took away your axe, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, boom. Travis's turn. Okay, Travis or Miss Trish. Do we have anything to kill yet with Miss Trish? I have the crawler down there. I mean, Skinner. I'm going to start with...
Forget it.
I'm going to start with Travis and search.
Yeah.
Plenty of ammo for shotguns, sawed-offs, Maz shotgun, etc. So shotguns. Don't have that yet, but I can't do anything with that.
You'll level up.
Oh, I guess I could pick up one of these X's. Do I want to do that, though?
That would specifically just be leveling up our characters.
Yeah, like, I think
they don't do anything for the mission.
I think Travis is going to need it because he doesn't have any weapons right now to get experience.
Yeah, so maybe so I don't fall behind.
Yeah.
I'll just go north and grab that 1X. What do you think?
Yeah. I mean, nothing's going to spawn. We're still in blue.
Okay, I'm going to go north, and I'm going to grab that X just for funsies. Let's do this thing, boys. Boom. 1X, 5 XP. Oh, and I got the we gotta play some of the new ones. The
objective achieved.
It's not really an objective, but it works. It's an objective. In Mrs. Trier.
I just feel like maybe Travis could catch up because he's the one with the Reaper, but in either case.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Hey, thanks, Greg, for hanging out. I appreciate it. Thanks for staying up late to catch it. Leave us some comments. Tell us what you think. Okay, Miss Trish. We're hanging out in the thing here. I'm going to go. I need range, so I'm just going to go.
All right, good night. Good night, Greg. Thanks for stopping by.
Going to keep us moving forward. Got the MAC-10, dude. Lore.
Oh, this is perfect. For
I'm going to get lore. One action to reload. You got to reload these. Nice, cool. But I got my MAC-10. Oh, dude, I got my lore.
Yep.
Hype train. All right. So with this, I'm just going to move forward. And I'm done. Lyle.
Let me start with Padre.
Mm-hmm.
Padre. And I'm going to go in and I'm going to search.
Padre's going to go in and throw up a search to the west. Double barrel.
Nice. Oh, that...
I don't think we played with this yet.
What is this? One action reload. Okay. Two dice, three plus. That's cool.
Two dice, three plus.
All right. Put Betty in the back.
Betty in the back. Nobody puts Betty in the back.
And then I'll move north, I guess.
Move north. All right, man. We're racing. Oh, I activated him. Ended his turn. Okay, Bear.
Bear's going to go... in and search.
Bear's going in. Throws up a search. We got a lot of melee, man. Like another red weapon, the 9/11 special.
Jeez. Okay.
Great. Ultra red. Okay.
And then move north. Yeah, what was the range on the double barrel? Maj is saying it had a pretty good range.
I think it's 3.
O to 2.
Jeez, that's awesome.
Nice, man.
That's strange. Usually double barrels have...
Yo, somebody shotgun, give me somebody give me that plenty of ammo.
Is this considered
that's
a shotgun?
All I'm saying.
I don't know if
that's all I'm saying.
I guess it's a shotgun, right?
No.
I guess if the car doesn't specifically call it out, then I can't use it.
Yeah, let's see. Let me check it. Sawed off shotgun or Moz shotgun.
No, then it doesn't work for it.
I mean, I'll give it to you and see if the app just picks it up.
Oh, app hack?
Yeah, app will app hack this thing. Hashtag app hack. All right, dude. Let's see where these things end up. Ooh. Roll the dice.
All right. Yeah, Napalm says it won't work with double barrel.
That's silly. Okay. Oh, three ones.
One, one, one. And a five.
One, 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 and a five. Okay, let's see what we get. Boom. Oh, we got the toxic. Toxic there. Oh, another toxic. Let's keep
another
it.
Another toxic. Yeah. Just...
Only... Keep the
Rudy
going.
More toxic.
Oh, we got the Skinner.
Skinner?
Superintendent Chalmers.
The lighting in here today is like all wonky.
Oh, plenty of arrows. Oh my god.
Plenty of arrows?
Plenty of arrows.
Have we not
Green
gotten
arrow.
That yet? Oh, or is that from Black Plague?
Hawkeye
oh, it's a Black
style.
It's a Black Plague. Oh, and we didn't do the activations yet. No, you're right. I forgot to move them. So, last spawn. Good catch, JXM. Thank you. And then we got a fatty.
OG fatty. Huh. Maybe we should have picked somebody with a lock it down skill.
What's the lock it down skill?
You can close the door.
Yeah, we could like close this door behind us.
Closing doors requires a special ability.
Who has Lock It Down, though? Because before, the Lock It Down was an advertised skill, but then no one had it until, I don't think, now, right?
Sean Connery has it, didn't he?
Yeah.
I can't find my car keys.
Or he used to, and then they took it off the list.
Have you seen my car keys? I was looking for the Rock.
What? That's terrible. That's awful.
Have you seen my car keys?
Oh, Captain Napalm saying still nobody has it. Okay.
No, still, see, yeah, because it would be ridiculous. I think it would break some of these missions. At least some of the challenges of them. The risk would go way down. All right. I think it's time for a break. I think we'd take a quick edit break here. Sorry we went a little bit long there, but we're now set. I'm going to have to clear. We made no noise that time, amazingly, because we lost all our weapons that can make noise and didn't have to open any doors. So it's going well.
We only want crowbars and bows, people. That's all we want.
So season 3 is off to a good start. We're having all kinds of tech issues, so it's straight up a Crit Camp show. This is going well. Yep. Lyle can't hear anything. Andrew's mic was giving crap. My cameras are shutting down.
I can hear things now.
I bought the old school Crit Camp live tonight.
You did, man. Thank you. And you're in the room. I appreciate you didn't change your location. And I'm still waiting for your dryer buzzer to go off or whatever that was that one time. But yeah, man, this is gonna go well, and hopefully it's not like Classic Crit Camp where it's gonna take us 10 tries to get through the first mission of the season. It's not gonna end up like that, Angelo. We're not gonna go down like that. We're beating this tonight, and it's an easy. By the way, this mission's rated as an easy 60-minute, so we should defeat this thing. So we'll be right back for part 2 of episode 64, season 3, Rue Morgue, mission 1.
And I actually need a break.
And Lyle needs a real break, so he'll be right back. But on YouTube, you don't know that. He's just going to disappear, and we'll be right back.
All right.